Well, hello there, this is MDW coming back to you from Subnautica in my little habitat of humble abode. Right. Seeing as I went a slightly different way than should really have been done, I want to go to the Mushroom Caves. I also want to go down to, or over to the island. I want to get that done as well. But before I do that,
this is Life Pod 7. Coordinates attached. Pod is structurally sound, but the fabricator's bust. Requesting assistance. 7 out.
Signal coordinates corrupted. Approximate transmission origin.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Okay. Where are you? So we've got Life Pod 4, which is right next to the Aurora. Life Pod 6, that's down in the Kelp Zone. No, that's not the Kelp Zone, it's Red Fern Zone. And that looks like it's got a whole load of crags. Right, where am I going? I'm trying to get down to... Right. I am going to do this slightly different this time. I've already been to the Aurora, already been to the weapons platform. So I think the next one out is going to be these three. Or actually, I'm going to try and find these three ones here. Or these life pods 4, 6, and 7. They've changed that tune, I swear they have. 4, 6, and 7, I'm going to try and find. At the same time, try and get down to the mushroom biome as well. That's the plan. So, first one, Aurora. This way. I'll see you when I get there. Okay, so as you see, I'm now running parallel with the Aurora, looking for this life pod that is on the surface. Where are you? There you are. I don't remember ever getting attacked, but you never know. Part that there. Creature decoy. Definitely take that. Right, move. Alright, one down, two more to go. That one's open. Alright, gonna try and get to the crag if I can, which is, if I remember rightly, at the back of the ship. The problem is, I remember there being a Leviathan back there. Shut up, Stalker. Don't worry, I hear you. I hear it. Should be down and around here somewhere. The crags. Oh, this definitely looks like craggy terrain to me. Shut up, sand shark. Ah! Pod 7. This is that one.
Passing 100 meters.
Yep.
Oxygen efficiency decreased.
Hey! An unusual doll. Okay.
PDA
data. Right. Back up to sunlight and make my way back and try and find the next life pod. Ooh, that took about 15% of my health off, that did. So, 6. Not sure whether I've already been there yet, so. I'll be back once I find it. Okay, so there's 17 again. Apparently, 2 fell down this area. And that looks like a way down into the mushroom forest. So, what I'm going to do. Alright, beacon 1. An entrance to mushrooms. Beacons. You can go to the red. Sea moth. You can be yellow. You can be orange life pod. Alright. So the hunt continues for life pod 6. Okay, we're back. I couldn't find life pod 6. I had a look around, just couldn't see it. Couldn't do a new pearl. A new thing. No. A wiring kit and fiber mesh. 2 silver ore. Okay, let's get 2 silver. Let's just hope I got enough silver. Yes. You. fiber mesh. Where are you? Here you are, creep vine samples. Oh, yep, there's the right one. I do hope they're going to fit. Hoping with him even being so equipment one rebreather. I think I'm gonna need that. Alright. Switch that to that because I'm definitely gonna need that. Drop some stuff off. Open that. Put that in there. That. Do I have the blueprint for any of the chargers? No, I don't. Dang it. What do I have on me? Do I need to get rid of anything? No. Oh, yeah. Titanium, titanium, and... don't really need that, so I'll drop that back in there. Still got four of them, down to one of them. I'll open up that locker. Neither. Make some bleach. Make some water. Thank you very much. Okay, that took a little bit longer than I wanted it to actually get to what I needed. Right. Jellyshroom Caves. That's where I said I was going to go to next. I'll be right back. I'm here again. Okay, new plan, don't hit anything. Let's repair this. Just about to say that became very deadly quiet then. Okay. Ooh. Looks like I've already found one of their little habitats. Definitely take that. Anything down? What was that?
Conditions in this cave support a microcosm of unique, possibly predatory life forms.
Great.
Detecting an artificial structure somewhere in the region.
Ah, spotlight.
New blueprint acquired.
Anything more? Nope. Let's get back in here, refill oxygen. Let's try. Okay. Okay, that's an empty one. Ooh, that was close. Hey! Get away from my ship. Grab snake. Come here. Gotcha. Oh, crap, you little bugger. Get off. Okay. Suicide. Great. Water.
Vital signs stabilizing.
Might as well eat some food as well. Get some health. Let's continue exploring. Oh, what's that? It's like a small platform.
Signal location uploaded to PDA.
Yeah. What we got? Environment log, pull toggle request, cross-referencing local environment scans with ideal habitat construction conditions. I don't like the sound of that. Results: large subterranean cavern with multiple entrances. Conditions support a unique microcosm of predatory life forms. Minor structural instability in cave walls. Extensive resource deposits. I saw you at the top of my screen. I see you. Extensive resource deposits, average environment safety rating C. Optimal habitat site rating B. Site 7 has been selected as the optimal habitat construction site for the following reasons: close proximity to one of the cave entrances in case of emergency, medium distance from predatory organisms, and stable foundations which to build. Ready access to materials. Signal tracking to the site has been created. Where? There. There, so I can get that. Okay. So apparently, it's over this way. Geothermal vent. What's that? Ooh, magnetite. Definitely need that. This way. Excuse me, fishies. Over that way. Yes, the battery. Thank you. Okay, over there. Screw off. Thank you. Okay. Ooh, multi-purpose. Definitely need that. I see you. Yeah, what we got? Observatory. Whoa, almost.
Discovered.
Ooh, that was close. I wonder if I can hurt these things.
Mm-hmm.
let's get back in here. I'll put myself over here. Modification station. Oh, definitely need that. Stasis rod. I think I'm going to leave these goodies around the outside. That sounded big. Up two. Three. A full papyrus. Thank you. Ooh, thermal plant. Alright. Where's the other piece? Oh, I think I just got one. That's fine. I'm gonna get attacked in a minute. Oh no, I am. Get back in here, refresh my. Okay. Where are you? There you are. Alright, in.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Okay. Like all good people, save the game. Because I ain't losing my progress now. I don't care what anybody says, save's coming or not. Definitely needs to. That PDA.
Integrating new PDA data.
Come on. I'm limited oxygen here. You. Anything? No. PDA. No. Oh. Follow the gassy. Okay. Alright. Refill my oxygen without getting caught on something? Oh, hello. Yes,
signal
that.
Location uploaded to PDA.
Okay. Let's got my oxygen back. Oh. Alright, let's see. Nothing that way, nothing that way. This way? Anything? Ooh. Ultra high capacity bank, thank you. What was that? A wool planter, okay.
New blueprint acquired.
EDA, thank you. Anything more here?
New EDA data.
Alright, time to. Oh, apparently. Looks like there's a PDA there, but maybe not. Alright, time to book it. Okay, let's get out of here quickly. Repair the old girl. Fitness. Right, okay. Let's just pull over to here quickly. What have we got? A load of blueprints. What have we got here?
I thought it might get claustrophobic living underwater. Father feels it is. He'd tell me it was childish, but I stare out of the window and sometimes I think how lucky I am to see this world up close. Back on the island, I wouldn't have believed the creature. creatures that live down here. The fish, they glow. There's one that's 90% eyeball. Snakes twice the length of a habitat compartment. Certainly, it's not all friendly. Most of the plant life is toxic. Learned that the hard way. But I've managed to coax some marble melons into growing indoors. And when they don't cover our dietary needs, well, we eat the fish themselves. It's a bit gross, but it's nothing they wouldn't do. I've been attempting to document my findings. Father approves. He says, understanding is power. That the more we know about this planet, the more we can use it to our advantage. I'm just doing it because it's fun. It's not easy without proper equipment and network access, but the old-fashioned way, observing, taking notes, testing theories, shows me the world in a way a spectroscopic analysis never could. Lately, I've been watching the crab snakes. They ambush their prey as it tries to feed on the mushrooms they hide in. What they don't eat settles on the seabed, which fertilizes the mushrooms, which feeds the herbivores, and so the chain continues. Co-evolution gives me the fuzzies.
So, sounds like Bart Torgel is a biologist? Okay, Bart Torgel's log number 2, Stalker Teeth.
Something incredible just happened. Since we're down here, I had this plan to build equipment and study the life forms we were encountering, but I didn't have enough enameled glass. So, I started looking for a natural substrate that would strengthen the glass we have, and those stalker teeth we've been finding fit the bill. Only, well, we needed more. That's when Marguerite got interested. She actually listened to me, more than I can say for Father. And I worked up the courage to talk about my more tentative theories. When I told her they were attracted to metal deposits, that their teeth get dislodged when they pick them up, her eyes narrowed and she dashed out of the room. 3 hours later, she came back, her pack loaded down with stalker teeth. I asked her about it. She shrugged and said my theories were good. Said she had the meeting out of the palm of her hand. I think she meant it literally. She is incredible. She went out to the kelp forest armed with just a heat blade and went fin to fin with a pack of stalkers. On the one hand, that is the coolest thing I have ever heard. On the other, well, I hope the stalkers didn't come off worse than Marguerite did. She had a huge gash on her forearm. I don't think things went as smoothly as she made out. And what's the point in surviving here if we have to kill everything that makes it so wonderful?
True.
I wish I knew more about these animals. But Father won't let me leave the habitat. Maybe with all this glass, we could build a containment unit and get up close to them.
Hmm? It's good hypotheses. Log 5.
Son, there is always a pecking order. And in our world, money makes a hierarchy. I pay Maida a fraction of what I pay you, and you a fraction of what I pay me.
If money makes the hierarchy, why is Marguerite making the decisions?
We need her. We let her think what she likes, so long as she does what she's told.
What if she doesn't?
For enough money, she will. People always do.
That was too close. Log 6, deeper.
We're already 200 meters below sea level. You want to go deeper?
Look around us, Chief. Water leaking through the hull, water outside the hatch. We're drowning. Real slow. If rescue arrives, whatever shot us down, it's gonna do it again and again until it's shut off. You see an off switch around here, Chief?
Why would it any more likely be half a kilometer down?
Your kid found something on the scanner. There's something down there. Something that shouldn't be.
You're mad!
I'm going all the same, and I've an idea you two are gonna follow. But if you do, be mindful. Your authority stopped at sea level.
Marguerite sounds, like somebody you don't want to pee off on a bad night. Or bad day, either way. Okay, log number 2 of Paul Torgel.
You know what Maida told me today? She wants to build build a habitat 500 meters below sea level, more than a kilometer northeast of here. She needs Bart and I to do it. She's got it into her head that she can save us if she just acts recklessly enough. But I've hauled Star Wars to Neptune, Plasteel to the Federation. This family operates 9 different mining colonies across the Ariadne Arm. Maida thinks she's better suited to lead. Her contract still says otherwise. But I just cannot damn well tell whether it's the stupidest idea I ever heard, or my only hope. I turned 80 years old last week. I thought I had another 80 in me, but marooned on this planet, there's no swapping out of my liver when the old one fails. Here, I'm mortal. The Maida is useful. So, it's my responsibility to make a decision. Return to the island and hope whatever knocked the Degazi out of the sky won't do the same to the rescue ship. Or take us deeper in search of answers. And all the while be hoping old age gets me before the sea monsters do. I'll give Maida just one thing. She was right about these caves. There's enough lithium there to fabricate 100 tons of plasteel. Enough for a damn fleet of Cyclops submarines. There was nothing anyone could have done to avoid crashing here. But I was right to order the detour. If we get off this planet, they'll be talking about the Torgel share price on the other side of the Federation.
So this family, the Torgels, operates 9 different mining colonies. They must be seriously well off. Let's have a quick look around, see if I haven't missed anything. I've already been there. Screw off. Scan this? Okay, push. Oh, I can. Cool.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Right. I think I found everything down here. Thank you, Cindy. My last bottle. Damn it. Alright. I'm thinking crash into those and then find my way back out, which looks like I already have. Did I ever scan a reef back? I don't remember if I did or not. These things are beauties. I mean, just look at the size of my sea moth compared to that. It's always a reassuring sound to them that always, you know, makes me feel good. Right. Let's get back to the pod and the base. Right.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Thank you, Cindy. We are back. There. There. Oh, that's full. Dang it. It's full. Open that. Oh boy. Okay. Now comes the fun part. Take that out, and I shall put... Where are you? Oh, I can't put that away, damn it. Two berries, one power cell. That can go in there for now. Alright, so mushroom forest, done. Out of the way, still got to find pod 6. Not sure where that is at the minute. I know, from what I saw, as you can see, it's in one of the reed beds. I know it is. I'm looking for that, but I haven't found it yet. Alright. What I think I can do... which side? Should be this side. Is... should I go and try out one of the... Alright. Already found that. I can turn that beacon off now. Already found... Excuse me. I thought I found it. What was that? Actually, you know, sir. Well, I'm not going to go any further at this moment in time. Getting down to the mushroom caves and finding those pods that I really needed to find. I think that's all going to do me for now. I'm going to do a little bit of work on my base. Get some stuff ready and prepared for the next episode. And I will see you in the next one. I will say, toodly pipsky. Have fun. Don't die. To Reaper Leviathan. Bye bye.